Namaste ji.
Om Pakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Sama Prabha Nirvignam Kurme Deva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada Sarasvati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupidi Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatume Sada Ishvaro Guru Ratneti Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Gurave Sarvalokanam Bishaje Bhavaroginam Nidhaye Sarvavidyanam Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Sada Shiva Samarambham Shankaracharya Madhyamam Asmadacharya Paryantam Vande Guru Paramparam. Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Sakshat Kritam Dayanandam Paramartha Swarupinam Tattva Jnana Prashastaram Karnatosmi Parampadam Om Sahana Vavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvina Vadhitamastama Vidvishavahai Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Yeyam Prete Vichikitsa Manushye.
Yeyam Prete Vichikitsa Manushye.
Astitye ke nayam astiti chaike.
Astitye ke nayam astiti chaike.
Etad vidya manushishtastvayaham.
Etad vidya manushishtastvayaham.
Varanamesha varastrutiyah.
Varanamesha varastrutiyah.
I'm sharing the Bhashya file also on this mantra. That also we can chant. I will chant, you can repeat after me. The last class I explained, so we'll continue with that. Eta vadhi atikrantena. What am I highlighting from there? Yeta vadhi atikrantena vidhi pratishedhartena.
Yeta vadhi atikrantena vidhi pratishedhartena.
Mantra brahmanena.
Mantra brahmanena
avagantavyam
avagantavyam
yat varadvayam suchitam
yat varadvayam suchitam
vastu
vastu
na
na
na na
atmatattva visaya yathatmya vijnanam
Atmatatvijayatam.
Okay, you can mute now. Etavadhi atikrantena vitipatishedhartena mantra brahmanena avagantavyam yatu varadvayasuchitam vastu na atmatattva vishe yathatme vijyanam. After the 19th mantra, Bhashyakara starts his commentary on the 20th mantra and gives an introduction to it. Eta vadhi atikrantena, what has gone by so far? That is what Bhagavad Pada refers to. What has gone so far? That varadvayam, the two varas, which the Nachiketa asked Yamadharmaraja, that varadvayam, which symbolizes Veda Purva. We know that the whole Veda, the voluminous Veda, the voluminous Veda Pramanam is divided into two portions. The first bulky portion, that is Veda Purva, which has Samhita, Brahmana and Aranyaka, divided into three. Samhita portion, Mantra portion, and second one Brahmana, and third one Aranyaka. So Mantra, Brahmana, Aranyaka. Mantra Brahmanena Avagantavyam, Bhagavad Pada mentions in the Bhashya. So Veda Purva, which consists of Samhita, Brahmana and Aranyaka, it enjoins karma, certain karma to be done. That is why Veda Purva, it is called Karma Kanda. It talks about karma, varieties of karma. Varieties of karma, Vaidika karma, which a person can do or sometimes must do. And when we say karma, this karma can be either kayika or vachika or manasa. Karma can be accomplished, can be done by either by the body or by the speech, by the words. The mantras are chanted, mantra brahmana. So vachika or by manasa, manasa karma. Manasa karma is meditation. So the karma part of the Veda can be done by kayika, vachika, manasa, any one of the three, or combination of more than one, or combination of all the three. Either by one or combination of more than one or of all the three, the karma and the karma pala is accomplished. This is what Veda Purva is. That is what the first two boons symbolizes. The first two boon, varadvayam, Pratama Varam, Dutiya Varam, Trabhyam Suchitam, Veda Purva Suchitam, Varadvayena Suchitam. And the last portion of the Veda is Vedanta, otherwise called Upanishad, where no karma is prescribed by the Veda. No karma is enjoined by the Veda. There is no prescription or there is no prohibition because it doesn't deal with karma. Therefore, it is only jnanam. It deals only with jnanam. Therefore, Vedanta is It's otherwise called Jnana Kandam, the portion of the Veda which deals with knowledge, Jnanam. If at all karma is there, karma is only in Upasadhanam, approaching the teacher, that is only karma, and exposing oneself to the teaching of the Shastra, that is only karma. Otherwise, there is no karma. So, Vedanta is Jnana Kandam. It deals with Jnanam, therefore Jnana Kandam. And what is the result of karma? Any karma? Karmana Parichinna Palam. By karma, the karma palam, what one gains is parichinnam. It is limited. Karmana parichinna palam. Parichinnam. Anityam. Anitya palam. And the palam can be enjoyed either in this bhumi, in this earth, or in the world we go after this life. Afterlife palam in the other loka, amutra palam. So, iha mutra palam. Karmana parichinna palam, iha mutra palam. Limited. The palam which is enjoyed in this loka or in the other loka, it is also going to be limited. Why? Because karma is parichinnam, it is limited. Parichinna karmana parichinna palam. Action being limited, it gives only limited results. Why action is limited? Because there is no limitless action. Why? Because karma is performed with limited accessories, karakam. Any karma, if you take, it is accomplished with the karakas. Karaka is a big topic. In Sanskrita Vyakaranam, we study Karaka. Some of you already know what Karaka is. Without the accessories, the factors of action involved in karma, karma cannot be done, and they are limited. Therefore, karma must be limited. Karma is limited. If you are performing a karma with your body, body being limited, the result of karma as a consequence of your bodily effort, that also will be limited. Body being limited, with a limited karma, you get accomplished limited karma phalam. Karma phalam in the form of sukham, dukkham, they are limited. Parichinnam. That is why svargaloka phalam, naraloka palam, they are limited. There is no eternal enjoyment in swarga or in naraka. It cannot be eternal. Because kaya, vak, manasa, body, speech, mind. With this, whatever you accomplish, it will be limited because they are limited. Vak, kaya, manasa, they are limited. And with this, we do karma. Karma kritam. So therefore, kritena karmana, the karma which is done with these accessories, with these tools, kritena karmana, parichinna karmana, what is obtained? Dharmartha kama purushartha labhyante. That is what is subject matter of Veda Purva. With limited karma being limited, parichinna karmana, what we get is limited results in the form of dharma, artha, kama, purushartha. If artha is the purushartha, artha is the life goal. If kama is the life goal, they are all life goal, limited within this life. Therefore, dharma is also limited. Dharma, even if you extend after life, that is also limited in the other loka, paraloka. Therefore, dharmartha kama this Trivida Purushartaha Parichinnaha, limited, Anityaha. Anityaha, they cannot be eternal. They are not eternal. It is not Nityam. They are not permanent. Therefore, the subject matter of Veda Purva is different from Vedanta. Vedanta talks about the Vastu, Vastu Tattvam, the knowledge of the truth of the reality, which doesn't require karma. Whatever I achieve by karma, since it is going to be finite, since it is going to be limited, that karma cannot give me absolute freedom. Karma cannot give me absolute security. That karma cannot give me absolute happiness. Because karma is parichinnam, limited. If at all moksha, absolute freedom, it is possible, it must be achievable only by jnana, not by karma. Because what is absolute, what is total, what is complete, what is unlimited, that cannot come under the purview of karma, karma kanda, Veda Purva. Therefore, if moksha is absolute freedom, it is not achievable by karma. That is not the topic of Karmakanda. Therefore, nastya krita kritena, kritena karmana, akritaha mokshaha nasti. Moksha, which is absolute freedom, which is akritaha, which is not created, which is not produced. Moksha is akritaha. And kritena karmana, karma which is done by one or more karakas, it cannot produce moksha, because moksha is not kritaha. Moksha is akritaha. Kritena karmana akritaha mokshaha nasti. Parikshalokan karmachitan brahmanaha nirvedamayat nastyakritakritena. It comes in Mundaka Upanishad. Akritaha mokshaha kritena karmana na bhavati. Moksha is absolute freedom. It cannot be produced. It cannot be created. Either you have it or you don't have it. If you have it, you enjoy it all the time. If you don't have it, then it is not possible to gain it. Because anything you gain by karma, it is going to perish in time. Because karma is done at a particular place, at a particular time, and depends on many accessories, karakas, therefore it is going to be parichinnam and it cannot give you absolute freedom. Therefore, moksha must be akritaha, nakritaha, akritaha. That which is absolute cannot be gained by karma. If moksha cannot be gained by karma, then what it is? Moksha cannot be gained by karma. Then what is that nature of moksha? What is that? That must be my swarupam. It must be my swarupam. Swarupam of jiva, jivatma. Moksha is the swarupam of jivatma. The swarupam of jiva is chaitanyam, which is not gained. That which is swarupam, It must be intrinsic. It must be natural. If moksha is my swarupam, it cannot be gained. It is not possible to gain moksha by karma. The swarupam of Surya, Surya Devata, sun is light, light and heat. It is swabhavikam to Surya, Surya Bhagavan. It is not agantukam. It is not extrinsic. It doesn't borrow. Surya Bhagavan doesn't borrow light. Surya doesn't need any light for its illumination. In the presence of sun only, everything is illumined. The sun need not work to gain light. Similarly, the Swarupam of Jivatma, Jiva, is Moksha. Therefore, it is not for achieving. It is already achieved. Moksha is already achieved, already accomplished. It is Siddha Vastu. It is Siddha, already accomplished. Not something to be produced by any karma, any action. If moksha is Siddha Vastu, then why am I not enjoying, able to enjoy it? That is because of ajnanam, ignorance. That is because of ajnanam with which we come to the world. Because of ajnanam, the moksha, which is my swarupam, is not being enjoyed by me. I take myself to be a karta, a bhokta, but really speaking, I am not a karta, I am akarta, I am not a bhokta, a bhokta. That being not known because of ajnanam, we are in samsara. So, samsara karanam, ajnanam. And when ajnanam goes away, in the wake of jnanam, ajnanam goes away. Why? Because jnanam is virodhi to ajnanam. Jnanam is opposite to ajnanam. Light, like light and darkness, they don't coexist. In the presence of light, darkness goes away. A room may be dark for millions of years. It was dark, pitch dark. But the moment you light a matchstick, the darkness which was enveloping the room for millions of years, it disappears in no time. Similarly, we have taken many manushya janma, other janmas also, all because of anadi avidya vasanaya. We have passed through millions of wombs, we have taken different life, all because of anadi avidya, all because of the beginningless ignorance. That ajnanam goes away when jnanam comes. Because jnanam is ajnana virodhi. Even the ajnanam is lighted by jnanam only. Even the ajnanam. When you say, I don't know, that I don't know is lighted by, that is also known to you. That is also known to you. Therefore, it is also lighted by Chaitanya Man. And when the right knowledge takes place, as ajnanam is jnana virodhi, then you discover freedom which already you are. You discover your swarupa, which need not be gained, which is your swarupa. And therefore, to discover my moksha swarupa, to discover that I am already free, I need not do any pranayama. I don't have to do thousands of pranayamas. I need not do any severe tapas. I need not go for any pilgrimage. I need not take up any austerities. I need not take bath in the holy Ganga. I need not do any puja rituals. Nothing to be done because moksha is already siddham. But all this may help you in preparing for the knowledge to produce the result. All these are helpful in preparing you for the acceptance, for the reception of this knowledge. Therefore, they are only the secondary cause. All the karma, all the puja, everything is karma. Whether it is done by kayika, vachika or manasa, all the karma, they are only the secondary cause. Primary cause, the primary means to moksha, to freedom, is jnana. Because it is the subject matter of knowing. Moksha is already siddham. Therefore, I need to know, I need to discover. Therefore, the means is jnanam, knowledge. Atma is siddham. Atma is siddham. If Atma is to be gained, then this gained Atma also can be lost at a certain point of time. Therefore, Atma need not be gained. It is already Siddham. Therefore, with respect to Siddha Vastu, Atma, there is nothing to be done. No karma is required. Therefore, moksha is possible only by jnanam. Jnanena eva mokshaha, natu karmana. But karmas may be the secondary means, secondary cause. It may be the sahakarika karanam. It may help you in preparing yourself for the jnanam. Therefore, it is only sahakarika karanam, but not sakshat karanam. Sakshat karanam, direct means, is only jnanam. And the karma prescribed by the Veda Purva, all the karmas which the Veda Purva prescribed, which prescribes, they act as sakakarika karanam. It acts as sakakarika karanam. Therefore, people can take up the karma and fulfill the dharmartha, kama, icha. But for jnanam, sakshat, for moksha, sakshat karanam is jnanam. Therefore, you have to come to Vedanta. Sakshat karanam is Vedanta. And the karma which the Veda Purva prescribes are the karma which you do in the Laukika. Any karma, whether Laukika or Vedika, any karma if you take, it can produce only the four things. With karma, what you can obtain can be classified into four things. By through karma, you can reach a place. With karma, you can reach a place that is called apyam, apyam, vikaryam, samskaryam, utpadyam. This is the purview of karma. Through karma, you can reach a place. You can reach a place in terms of, you can reach in terms of time or in terms of place. Apyam, apyam karma. You want to go to Kailash Manasarovar. Therefore, there is a place to be reached. You want to go to Swargaloka. There is a distance involved. You go to Swargaloka after death. Therefore, it is apyam. It is to be reached. And for that, karma is there. Similarly, vikaryam. Vikaryam means modification. Changes. For change to happen, you can do the karma. Vikaryam. Samskaryam, for purification. For purification, certain karmas can be done. If you want to purify yourself, you take bath, snanam. But what does snanam do? Snanam, it removes the dirt. It purifies you. Therefore, samskaryam. It is samskaryam. Utpadyam. Utpadyam is produce. Not produce something which is not there in the world. You produce something with the available means. You produce something. It's a combination of certain things which gives to you a new thing, which is the combination. Therefore, utpadyam. So, apyam, vikaryam, samskaryam, utpadyam. Through karma, you can achieve only these four. This is a purview of karma. And moksha, which is absolute, it doesn't come under any of these four. Therefore, krita karmana akritaha mokshaha na sambhavati. Therefore, by apya, by vikarya, by samskarya, by utpadya, by any of this, moksha is not possible. And the karma which the Veda Purva prescribes, if it is whether it is Veda Purva, Vedika karma, or any Laukika karma, the karma comes under any of these four only, through which moksha is not possible. Krita karmana na bhavati mokshaha. Why? Because swasya swarupatvat mokshaha na kritaha. Moksha being the swarupa, therefore it is not produced, it is not created. Mokshaha na kritaha chet katam tarhi sambhavati jnanena eva. Only by jnana. Ajnana apagamanena eva moksha. That is why here Bhagavad Pada, he makes a distinction. Distinction between the first two boons, Pratama Varadvayam, which symbolizes Veda Purva, and the last boon, which symbolizes Mokshaha, Vedanta. Moksha is the subject matter of Vedanta. Therefore, yet varadvaya suchitam vastu. Vastu, varadvayam suchitam vastu. Vastu means any end. Purushartha. Here, vastu means purushartha. Suchitam. It is not sakshat prarthitam, it is suchitam. What is indicated? What is indicated by the first two boons? What is indicated? Arthakama. What is indicated by the first two boons is Arthakama. The first boon is Pitukushantihi. The second one, the Agni Vidya, that is also Arthakama only. Agni Vidya, which Nachiketa asked, it is meant for Dharma. Dharma meaning Punya. Dharma meaning Punya. That will be encashed for going to Swargaloka. So that by doing that Agni Vidya, the Vaidika Karma, Agni Vidya, you get Punya, and that Punya can be encashed for going to Swargaloka. And this is enjoined by the Shastram, Veda Purva. This is Vidikriya. This is enjoined by the Shastram, and the palam is Swarga palam. Swarge loke modate. That Kriya palam is Swarga loka. So there is a palam. So that Varadvayam, it will come under Dharmartha Kama only. Because it is Vaidika, related to Veda, therefore Punya is involved. Dharma is involved. Dharma meaning Punya. That karma produces Punyam. Therefore, the subject matter of Veda Purva is, the subject matter of the first two boons is within the Mantra Brahmana of the Veda. Mantra Brahmanena Avagantavyam. So, it is within the Mantra Brahmana of the Veda, which takes karma, which talks about karma in the form of Vidhi Pratishedha. In the form of Vidhi Pratishedha. Ataha Vidhi Pratishedhartha Vishayatmani. The next line it is there. So, it talks about karma in the form of Vidhi. That is, Vidhi is injunction. Nishedha is prohibition. Vidhi is injunction. Do's. Nishedha, prohibition. Certain kriya, certain karma the Veda prescribes, which one must do. They are vidhi kriya. Certain karma Veda prohibits, forbids one to do. Nishedha kriya. For example, himsam na kuryat, kalanjyam na bakshet, suram na pibet. Himsam na kuryat. Himsa is hurting others. So, imsam na kuryat. Why? Because hurting, it produces papam. It produces papam. Therefore, na kuryat. Don't hurt any being. And Veda, it says, may you lead a life of least hurting. So, imsam na kuryat. It is a nishiddha karma, nisheda. Because there is a possibility, there is a tendency to hurt. That one has to curb. Therefore, the Veda says, Imsam na kuryat. Since the possibility is that, therefore, Veda, it gives a vidhi, a rule, injunction. Prasaktasya pratishedaha, it prohibits, saying that Imsam na kuryat. Therefore, one has to protect oneself in not hurting others by action. By kayena, manasa, vacha, one should not hurt others. So one has to start from the kayikam first, then vacha, then later manasa. So what I am saying is that pratishiddha karma is there. Veda prescribes certain karma which to be done and some karmas which one should not do, prohibited. So vidikriya, that which enjoined by the Veda Purva, it brings punyam, punya palam. It brings desired ends. And nishiddha karma, pratishedha karma, it produces adrishta papam. Adrishta papam, it manifests in the form of unpleasant situations in life. Therefore, one set of karma is for avoiding and one set of karma is for doing. So therefore, the bulk of the Veda Purva, it prescribes karma to be done, certain karmas to be done. They are nitya naimittika karma. Nitya naimittika karma, daily and obligatory karma, duties. Certain karmas can be done, that is up to you. They are kamya karma. We have certain end to accomplish. Therefore, you can do certain karmas. Kamya karma. Karma which are motivated by your desire. They are kamya karma. And certain karmas not supposed to be done by you, but was done by you. You have done it. And therefore, to neutralize that, you do certain karma which are called prayaschitta karma. Karma for atonement. And another set of karma which one should not do, that is pratishiddha karma. So all this karma, nitya naimitika, prayaschitta, pratishedha, kamya karma, all these karmas are mentioned in the Veda. Itataha, in Veda Purva, you will find all the karmas are mentioned. And this karma portion of the Veda, they are analyzed in the Purva Mimamsa. Purva Mimamsa. In Purva Bhaga of the Veda, it is analyzed in depth in Purva Mimamsa. Mimamsa meaning analysis. Analysis of the Veda Vakya, that is called Mimamsa. Pujita Vicharaha Mimamsa. Revered inquiry on the sentences of the Veda, that is called Mimamsa. So, Purva Bhaga deals with all this karma. How do we know? Because in the Uttara Mimamsa, in the Vedanta, it is not done. Therefore, in the Purva Mimamsa, it is done. There is a certain order. Purva Mimamsa, it does analysis of karma, and Uttara Mimamsa, it talks about, deals with jnana, jnanam, vastu. Purva Mimamsa, it is done by Jaimini Maharishi. That is, he is the disciple of Vyasa. And Vyasa Maharishi, he analyzed Uttara Mimamsa. So, Guru, he took up the Uttara Mimamsa part, the later part of the Veda, and the Shishya took the first part. So, each shared the Veda for their analysis. They shared the whole Veda, and the first part taken by Jaimini, disciple of Vyasacharya, the later part by Vyasa himself. And therefore, the whole Shastra is now divided into two, Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa. And there is no contradiction between the two. The subject matter of the two portions of the Veda are different. Karma approach is different from the later part. Karma, which the Veda Purva deals with, it is different from the subject matter of the Vedanta. Therefore, Mimamsa, it's different. The Vedic sentences, the analysis of the Vedic sentences are different. Because the subject matter being different, therefore, the sentences have to be interpreted properly. That is why it is Shastra Dvayam. It is not Eka Shastram, it is two Shastrams. Because there are sentences in Vedanta where there is no karma, no karma is involved. And there is a Purva Mimamsa Sutra which says, Amnayasya Kriyarthatvat Anarthakyam Atadarthanam. This is how it starts, Purva Mimamsa. Amnayasya meaning Vedasya. Vedasya Kriyarthatvat, Kriyaparatvat, does commitment in doing Kriyarthatvat, Anarthakyam Atadarthanam. Anarthakyam means uselessness, no meaning. So anything other than karma, any sentences which the Veda talks other than karma, it is anartham, it is useless. So anything not connected with karma is useless, according to Purva Mimamsa. Therefore, their analysis of the first part is purely based, it's all karma based. All the sentences of the Veda, it is connected with karma. It is either it is a Vedic Kriya, must be done karma, or it is Pratishiddha, Pratisheda, Kartavyam Karma or Akartavyam Karma. Either to be done or not to be done. Iti Kartavyata. There are a lot of Iti Kartavyata is there. Iti Kartavyata means Vidhi. Kartavyam, to be done. Kartavyam, Karyam, Karma. But the later part of the Veda, Veda Purva, in which we find a lot of sentences, Veda Vakya, which has no connection with karma. Then how do you interpret? And this Veda Purva part of the Veda, which is mantra and brahmana, it talks about a lot of karma. And the Vedanta, the sentences of the Vedanta, the Veda Vakyas, it is not connected with karma. Therefore, the connection to be made, how the Purva Mimamsa, they make connection for them, how they make connection saying that it is Prashamsa Vakya, Arthavada Vakya iti. So they connect to the main Vakyas of the Veda either by Vidikriya or Pratisheda. Because their approach, their commitment is only in establishing the karma. Any Vedic sentences not connected to karma, they will try to connect with karma. If they are not connected to karma directly, they will make an indirect connection. Either they will say that sentences of the Veda as a prashamsa, as a praise, or as a arthavada. Somehow they connect the sentences, Veda Vakya, to karma. Because according to them, the tatparya of the Veda is only in karma. And therefore, the first two bones what Nachiketa asked, they are connected to Dharmartha Kama and the Paramapurushartha Moksha, which is the tatparyam of the later part of the Veda. It is a different topic. The prayojanam adhikari vishaya and sambandha, the anubandha chatushtayam of the first portion of the Veda, Veda Purva, it is different from the Vedanta. Any karma, if you take, whether it is Vaidika or Laukika, any karma, if you take, it requires karaka. Kriya nishpattav karakam. Nishpatti meaning coming into being, bringing into being. So any kriya, for performing any kriya, you need a karaka. Therefore, varieties of karakas are required. Varieties of karakas, there are only seven karakas. Seven karakas, either one or two or more than two, combination of more than two, all these karakas are required. All these karakas are required in accomplishing the desired end. In performing by doing a karma, all these karakas are required. Therefore, the Veda Purva, when it prescribes a karma, it prescribes all the karakas also. So the sentences of the Veda Purva, they connect to karma by karaka. For example, there is a karoti. I will explain what karaka is. For example, karoti is there. Karoti means doing. Does. Who does? Somebody is doing. The subject is there. The subject is in Veda Purva, the adhikari. The adhikari does. Adhikari does that in karma. With a particular desire to accomplish certain thing. Therefore, karma which is prescribed, kaha karoti, that adhikari. Someone does, or someone who is the adhikari, he does. How does he do? Kena karoti, by what he does? By gathering all the ingredients required for the ritual. And also by the priest. He does the karma. And kasmai karoti, for whom does he do the karma? He may do the karma either for oneself or for the others. So you can keep asking, karoti, the kru is there, doing is there. Once the doing, the action is there, you can ask these questions. Who does? With what he does? For whom he does? From where he does? And where he does, in terms of time and place, where it should be done. When it comes to Veda, should be done. Where should be done? Because it prescribes karma to be done karma. So, therefore, all the karakas are involved. All the karakas are involved in the Veda Purva. And you cannot perform any karma without minimum karakas. Without minimum karakas, no karma is possible. Whether in kartariya or karmani, karta must be there. Karta is must be there. Therefore, with kartru pradhanam, the karmas are kartru pradhanam. Kartru pradhanam means that it is pradhanam kartuhu icha pradhanam. The karta has got certain desire to accomplish. Therefore, karta is involved. Karta and its desire is involved. Therefore, that pradhanam. Kartu pradhanam. Therefore, no karakas are there, karta must be there. You cannot exclude karta. Karta is there, therefore, karma palam comes to karta and becomes a bhokta. So, therefore, karakas are there. Therefore, the whole karma kanda, it is based on karakas. What about Jnana Kanda? In Jnana Kanda, there is no action involved. No Kriya is involved in Jnana Kanda. Because Siddha Vastu Vishayatvat, Atmanaha Brahmanaha. Atma, it is Siddham. It is already accomplished. It is Atma is Brahma. Jivatma is Paramatma. The Jivatma, the Karmakanda Jivatma, it has to do certain action with all the Karakas, with all means with one or more or any of the combination of the Karakas, it has to do certain action for Dharmartha Kama Purushartha. That is Jivatma, Karmakanda Jivatma, whereas the Jnanakanda Jivatma, it doesn't have to do, because Atmanaha, Brahmanaha, it is Brahma, Atma is Brahma, Jivatma is Paramatma. There is no action involved on the part of Jivatma to join with Paramatma. There is no merging involved with Paramatma. Merging, when you say, that involves action, but there is no merging, because it is Siddham already. It is accomplished. Jivatma is Paramatma. Atma is Brahma. I am Atma Brahma. This self, this is Brahma. This self is Brahma, Paramatma. It is a fact. It is the truth. It is the reality. If it is a fact, as the Vedanta reveals, then I should see it. But I don't see it. Why? That is a problem. I don't see that Atma is Brahma. That is a problem. That is the Ajnanam. Because of Ajnanam, I am not able to see Aham Brahma Asmi. I don't see it. That is, I don't know. Therefore, Adarshanam. Not able to see. Not able to see the fact that Aham Brahma Asmi. That is a problem. This Adarshanam, not able to see. It is because of Ajnanam. This Ajnanam is not something special to anyone. It is the only capital with which we come. We start our life with this Ajnanam. And either we keep learning to remove this Ajnanam, or sometimes we keep maintaining this Ajnanam. The difference is only in that. Either by learning, either by discovering, we remove this Ajnanam, or we choose to maintain the Ajnanam. That is the difference between a samsari and a jnani. A jnani chooses to remove the ajnanam, and samsari chooses to remain in ajnanam. Therefore, what we should do is, when the time comes, this ajnanam should be knocked down. When we get a chance to get exposed to the shastram and guru upasadanam is done, then that's the right time to knock out this ajnanam. So therefore, ajnana nivritti, this ajnana nivritti alone, this ajnana nivritti alone is siddhavastu aptihi. Siddhavastu is already accomplished. There is no apyam, there is no to be reached. Atma being already siddha, siddhavastu, therefore, this ajnana nivritti, this removal of ajnanam alone is to be done by exposing oneself to the shastram. Because shastram, Vedanta, it gives jnanam, gives knowledge with regard to the truth of the reality about oneself. That jnanam removes ajnanam, ajnana nivrittihi. Therefore, the vakyas of the Vedanta, they are different from the vakyas of Veda Purva. Here, Siddhavastu Vishetvat, no Karakas are involved. It is already Siddham, accomplished. Therefore, nothing need to be accomplished. Only when you need to accomplish some certain things, then only the Karta, Karma, Karana, Apadana, all these Karakas are involved. All the other accessories are involved. All the factors of actions are involved. But here, the vakyas, the vakyas of the Vedanta, it deals with siddhavastu. Therefore, no karakas are involved. Therefore, no kriya. Therefore, there is no nitya naimittika. No such kriyas are involved. Kriya abhavat. Therefore, accepting Purva Mimamsa's argument. Accepting Purva Mimamsa's argument. Purva Mimamsa say human being is kriya oriented, is interested in doing karma. We always want to do something. Even for the spiritual progress, we want to do spiritual sadhana. Because only when I do, I feel I am spiritual. So we want something to practice. We want something to do daily as part of the spiritual sadhana. That is why every cult in the spiritual world, if you take, they prescribe certain action. They prescribe certain action because people want it. Because without doing anything, they don't feel accomplished. They feel they have not accomplished. It's all because of karma orientation. Karma to be done. I want to do. I want to. The doing is there. So it gives a certain sort of a mental satisfaction in doing. Therefore, every human being, either he loves to do something on its own, or he wants somebody to command to do. So that karma orientation is there. Whereas in I am Atma Brahma, in this Veda Vakya, Vedanta Vakya, there is nothing to be done. I am Atma Brahma, that's all. There is nothing to be done. But since there is nothing to be done here, therefore many, they don't have the liking to know, because there is nothing to be done. Since already they have the orientation of to be done, to do, that karma orientation is there. And when the Vedanta says that I am Atma Brahma, then they don't have the liking to know. Therefore, that desire to know, that jignyasa, the shift from Veda Purva to Vedanta, opting to know, it's a big thing. It's a very big jump from doing to knowing, from chikirsha to jignyasa. Chikirsha is kartum iccha, chikirsha. I want to do, that is Veda Purva. I want to know, that is Vedanta. I want to know, when you say, that is siddham. Siddhavastu vishayam, siddhavastu jnanam. So that is the subject matter of Vedanta. So therefore here, etavadhi atikrantena vidipradishedatena mantra brahmanena avagantavyam yat varadvaya suchitam vastu na atmatattva vishaya yathatmya vijnanam. So what is to be understood by the portion which has gone so far, atikrantena, so far covered by the first two boons, it is within the purview of karma, vidhi pratishedhartena, in the form of vidhi and pratishedha. It is not connected with atmana, atmanaha yathatmya vijnanam. Yathatmya vijnanam, yathatmya means yathasvarupam, yathasvarupam yathatmyam, knowledge in keeping with the truth. Yathatmya vijnanam, for which the subject matter is the truth of Atma. Therefore, what is avagantavyam, vardvaya suchitam, is not Atma Tattva Vishayam. It is not Atma Tattva Vishayam. The first two boons doesn't deal with Atma Tattva Vishayam. The subject matter is not the reality of Atma Tattva. There is no enquiry, vichara involved in the first two boons. There is no enquiry based on whether I am a karta or bhokta. No such questions are asked. I am karta, I am bhokta, that is assumed. Therefore, the first two boons, what Nachiketa asked, there, that assumption that agam karta, agam bhokta, it is there. No inquiry is there. No examination in the first two boons, which symbolizes the Veda Purva. Because without examination, without inquiry, taking oneself to be a karta and bhokta, we take up varieties of karma, we do. That Veda sanctions it. Because of our ajnana, we do take ourselves to be a karta, bhokta. And Veda accepts that you do because you want to accomplish certain things in life, which gives you a sense of self-satisfaction, a relative accomplishment. Therefore, Veda encourages. And no inquiry is involved. Therefore, no inquiry is involved. Because there is only accomplishment is involved. To achieve is involved. No inquiry is involved. But that is the samsara bija. That is the samsara bija. That is the seed of samsara. Therefore, ataha viti pradishedhartha vishayasya atmani kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa lakshanasya swabhavikasya ajnanasya samsara bijasya nivrityartam. Samsara bija. Samsara bija is ajnanam. Ajnanam is the samsara bija. Therefore, atmatattva yathatya vijnana abhava. Jnana abhavaha, which is the samsara bija. That is, Brahma aham asmi. Iti darshana abhavaha. Not able to see that aham Brahma asmi. Not able to see that aham Brahma asmi. That is ajnanam. That is the ajnanam. Not knowing agam Brahma, in fact, that is not the problem. If you don't know that you are Brahman, that is not the problem. But the problem is, if you don't know that agam Brahma asmi, I am Brahman, then you are going to take yourself to be different from what you are. You will take yourself to be a Brahma, other than Brahma, not Brahma. Therefore, you become limited. You take yourself to be limited. I am limited. I am insignificant. If you don't take yourself to be Brahman, if I am aham Brahma asmi, if this jnanam is not there, if you choose to remain ignorant, it is okay, but it will not stop there. That ignorance, the consequence of that ignorance will be that you will take yourself to be a Brahma, not Brahma. And you will start identifying with so many things and you become limited. And therefore, aham parichinnaha, I am limited, I am insignificant, you say. You won't be able to say, I am less limited. You won't be able to say, I am less limited. You cannot say, because if between the finite and the infinite, the distance is always limitless. Either you are unlimited or you are limited. You cannot be less limited. So therefore, there is no gradation in ajnanam. You are an ajnani. Therefore, if you commit a mistake against the limitless Brahman, then you are limited. And this adarshanam, this adarshanam, it leads to the mistake. Not knowing the truth, it leads to mistake. And atma being self-evident, it is not known. When it is not understood, then I take myself to be that which is near to me. I take myself to be this body, this mind, the senses. I take myself to be the sthula shariras, and it goes further down, further sukshma sharira, karana sharira. So with all this you identify and you become parichinna, you become abrahma, you become limited, you become insignificant. Therefore, svabhavikasya ajnanasya, that ajnana, which is svabhavika, which is natural. Natural means that ajnana, it is continues, that ajnana with what we continue our janma, and which is characterized by Kriyakaraka Pala Adhyaropa Lakshanasya. Characterized by, this Ajnana is characterized by Kriyakaraka Pala. Because Ajnanam is there, therefore Kriya is there, Karma is there. There is a pressure to do is there. There is a pressure to accomplish is there. Therefore, karma is involved. Kriya is involved. When kriya is there, karakas will come. And karakas are there. With karakas, you do karma, you do kriya, and therefore karma pala will be there. And the karma pala will further produces karma. And karakas are there. Again, karma pala. So karma. So goes on and on. So it's a cycle. And that is the adhyaropa. Adhyaropa lakshanasya. And that is samsara, which is the seed. Samsara bijasya ajnanasya nivrityartam, for the removal of that ajnanam, to break that cycle, uttara grantaha arabhyate. The later part of the text is started, going to be started. Here, when we say kriya karaka palam, that kriya karaka palam, is a nice way of expressing the dvaitam. Kriya karaka palam is when you say that karaka. Kriya is when you say kriya, that is the kriya with accomplished, the kriya which is done with karakas resulting in karma palam, it points to dvaitam. The whole dvaitam is aropitam. It is superimposed on advaita atma. It is superimposed on advaitam. Atma is advaitam. Atma is Brahma, which is advaitam, non-dual reality. On that, the whole dvaitam. Atma is akarta abhokta. On that, kartrutvam, bhoktrutvam is aropitam. Therefore, Kriyakaraka palam is dvaitam, which is aropitam on advaita atma. Therefore, to remove that, nivrityartam, for the removal of that, tad viparita, what is viparita? Opposite, ajnana virodhi, jnanam. Tad viparita, brahmatmaikatva jnanam. That jnanam is brahma atma ekatvam. Knowledge of the atma being brahma. Knowledge of Atma, the reality of Atma is Brahma. Atma being Brahma, there is no Jivatma joining with the Paramatma. This Ekatvam is not union, it is oneness. Non-dual reality. One non-dual Brahma, which is Kriya Karaka Pala Adhyaropa Lakshana Shunyam, which is characterized by the absence of Dvaitam. Kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa, which is lakshana shunyam, which is characterized by that brahmatma ekatva vijnanam, that knowledge with regard to that jiva being one with jivatma, being one with paramatma, which is characterized by the absence of kriyakaraka palam, that jnanam, which is ajnana virodhi, alone can do nivritti, samsara nivritti. Therefore, ajnanasya nivrityartam vijnanam apekshate. Therefore, for the removal of this ajnanam, vijnanam, jnanam is apekshate, it is required. Why? Because brahmatma vijnanam is the virodhi of ajnanam. Ajnanasya viroditvat. Like what? Like tamas prakashavat, light and darkness. In the presence of light, darkness goes away. Similarly, when the jnanam happens, ajnanam goes away. Ajnanam along with its roots, it goes away. Therefore, kriyakaraka pala adhyaropa lakshana shunyam atma Atyantika Nishreyasa Prayojanam Vaktavyam. Atyantika Nishreyasa Prayojanam. Absolute Nishreyasa. Shreyas is absolute good. Shreyas is moksha. The usefulness of knowing that usefulness of gaining, the prayojanam, the benefit of gaining, the moksha, vaktavyam, to be told, vaktavyam, therefore, to be told, therefore, uttara grantaha, the later part of the text, arabhyate, it is started. So, Bhagavad-pada, he gives a connection between the first two bones with the third bones, a connection between the Veda-purva and the Vedanta. There is a connection is involved, Veda-purva and Vedanta. It is not totally disconnected. Connection, after this is started. Athato Brahma Jignyasa. Even in Brahma Sutra, we say, Athato Brahma Jignyasa. Atha, after accomplishing, after gaining Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, then Brahma Vichara, Brahma Jignyasa, to be done. That is, a connection is involved. After accomplishing Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, how do you accomplish Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti? You will not directly jump to Vedanta. You all this examination, Pariksha Loka, you analyze the world. You analyze the world how you do karma. You realize the limitation of karma. The karma cannot make you unlimited, cannot give you security. It, karma, which is done to accomplish dharmartha kama, it cannot give you that security, that happiness, the freedom, what you want. So all this to be examined. The limitations have to be examined. That gives you the vairagyam. Therefore, athato, after accomplishing the qualifications by examining the world, you do the Brahma Vichara. You inquire into Brahman. That is what the Brahma Sutra, first Sutra, talks about. Athato Brahma Jignyasa. The connection is involved. Similarly, here also connection is there. Veda Purva and Vedanta, there is a connection. After the first two bones, which talks about the Dharmartha Kama Purusharta, after gaining and understanding the limitations, then you further ask, what is that gaining which I become ever free? I become happy, I become unlimited. That is what the Shaunaka also asked in Mundaka. Kasmin vijnate sarvamidam vijnatam bhavati. That jump, that has to come from karma orientation to jnana, from to do to know. That is what is indicated. That is what the connection is. That is what is indicated by the Bhagavad Pada here. Uttara grantaha arabhyate iti. The later portion of the text is going to be started. So, with this, the introduction to this mantra is completed. We have seen the mantra, Yeyam Prethi Vichikitsa Manushye. We will continue with the next mantra, 21. Achiketa, now he had asked the third boon of the Yamadharma Raja, is going to test Nachiketa with the 21st mantra onwards, and later, from the next chapter, from the next valli, he will start giving his teaching. We will see that in the next class. So we'll stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Thank you, Ji.
Dhanyavada.
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 Thank you.
Dhanyavada.